When we begin exploring more advanced knee down positions, we're talking about kickstand knee down stances. You may see individuals in the big leagues who are doing this, Jose Trevino, JT Realmuto, and many others use this position because it is a good way for them to move laterally and be able to block out of a knee down position. And generally, it's also one of the more comfortable positions for those who choose to work out of that stance. So whenever we are talking about a kickstand position, if I am in a standard right knee down stance here, or if I'm swiveled slightly more open towards third base, from here, I'm just going to rock and place that foot out to my side. So whether I'm working down to the ground, whether I'm working back into the body, I am still centered. My weight is relatively balanced between my right knee and my left foot, and I am in a good position to be able to receive the pitch, or if I have to work left to right, I feel like I can do so because I have the leverage in the ground. Whenever we are in that stance, I'm going to switch and face this way. We don't want our left leg to be directly in line with our right knee. If we do this, typically we are going to be a little bit more top heavy. We're not going to be able to get into our hips as well, and we are going to be a little bit more stuck. A simple solution to this is bringing that left foot out in front of our body slightly, so now I can sink into my left hip and I'm in a good position to where I can work out in front of my body, and I'm creating a ton of space to use to receive or do other things that are required of me. Whenever we start talking about a left knee down kickstand, the same things apply. I don't want to be too tall. I don't want to get stuck against that right leg. I want to make sure that I'm bringing that foot a little bit more out in front of my body. And we're using any one of these stances that is comfortable for us, so long as we can get relatively centered, our chest isn't going to be too high, and we don't feel stuck in any way working into that stance. Again, to reiterate, we have to make sure if we are going to use one of these stances in a game, we have to be able to dominate receiving, blocking, and throwing if the situation calls for it, if it's a two-strike count, or if there's runners on base. We cannot allow those guys to get to second base, third base, or home. So whenever we're working out of these stances, just to recap, making sure that we are still centered, we are still grounded, and we're in a good position as far as our target, our posture, and everything else that we have talked about is concerned. If we get too much in line, we might feel stuck in that left hip. We can bring that foot out slightly and bring our chest forward to where we're in a similar posture and position at our chest to if we were working on 2 feet. And we can still work out in front of our body and work to receive these pitches without being in a more uncomfortable position to work from.